So this is my new 2023 Honda Accord Hybrid. This is the sport version with the leather. So my previous car was a 2020 Accord, and it was the EXL 2.0 turbo. So I have the window stickers here, and I'm gonna show you a few items that you do not get with the new one. So hopefully this, you'll be able to read this. So there is no 2.0 turbo anymore. Everyone kind of knows that already. That kind of sucks. And for the higher end Accords, you have to get the hybrid. There is no 10-speed automatic transmission, no paddle shifters. They do have paddle shifters, but they're only for regenerating the hybrid, to basically recharge the battery. They're not actual paddle shifters for the transmission. Hill start assist, I don't believe that's a part of this hybrid anymore. The stereo system, instead of having 10 speakers like my 2020 had, it only has 8. The Honda Link is no longer there. I believe that was on the mirror. That's no longer standard. And the Sirius XM, no longer standard. The push button shifter is gone. Now you have a stick. The rear console vents, you get no vents for the rear passenger, sorry. You have 10-way drivers, power seats instead of the 12 on the previous car. Auto dimming rear view mirror, nope, you're not gonna get that standard. Honda Link system, nope. You get one 12-volt power outlet, the previous car had 2. Blind spot information system, you pay extra for that. I believe it's $550 if you can find them. Most cars, they don't even have them. I think it's part of the chip shortage. LED fog lights, you get no fog lights with this car. Heated power door mirrors with turn indicators, nope, you don't get that either. The dual chrome exhaust finishers, no. And maybe because of hybrid, that's not a thing anymore. Another thing that I've noticed was on the previous car, 65% of the parts content were US and Canadian. And a big part of that is the engine was also made in the United States, where now I believe the engine is made in Japan and only 50% of the car parts are US and Canadian. I think that is mainly because the engine is made in Japan. So here is the hybrid, or this was the 2.0. Annual fuel cost was $1,500. And the hybrid, you're at $1,000. The EPA for the sport is 44, with 46 in the city and 41 in the highway. And just for reference, the 2.0 was 27 was the average, with 23 in the city and 34 on the highway. So if you have the older model and you really like it, keep it, because you're going to lose a few things that used to be standard you never even thought about, but that's the way it is, and it's too bad.